Welcome here to this lecture course on programming with MATLAB and Octave. Here the first chapter we get started. The outline of the course is the following. Clearly we have to go through the basics and the environment of MATLAB or Octave. Then in the second or third chapter we already look at for and while loops, at the if structure. And pretty soon we'll discover that it's damn easy in these environments to actually plot data, that is, produce nice looking graphs of data. Later on we'll look at functions and write and read data. The whole thing is intended to give you a tool to present data, to analyze your own data, and we'll go through a number of exercises, and hopefully you will try yourself to solve those. Later on we'll discover that it's a good tool to analyze medical engineering data or other applications from sport science or optics. So the whole thing is about learning by doing. So practical examples, and you will hopefully discover that you get a tool for the analysis of data. The whole thing is a layman's approach, that is, get your hands dirty and into the data. But first of all we have to learn how the tool actually works. So why MATLAB and Octave? MATLAB is a commercial package. Here's a website of the company behind it. It's quite expensive. It costs for a single user license roughly 1,400 euro to start with, though that is a price for commercial use, that is, in companies, for instance. For universities, it's much cheaper or even free. And the thinking, obviously, of the company is that they would like you to get hooked and ask your boss later on in the job that you can't live without it. So Octave is a cheaper alternative. It's free, it's freeware. It's fine for the beginning for what we do here in the whole course, in this whole lecture course, it's fine. The environment looks similar, in some respect even simpler. It's compatible with MATLAB, so when you write a program in MATLAB, you should be able to transfer to Octave and run it there. The standard program, the standard commands are the same, though you will discover that later on, for advanced users, MATLAB is better, quicker, and has more options. But anyway, here it would be fine to use Octave and everything is ready and should work smoothly. Okay, that's enough. We get started. So let's have a look at the MATLAB environment. I've prepared a script of all the stuff I'm talking about here, and I'll present that you can download it. Though here I'll go through the MATLAB window and environment and explain while I'm doing that. So when you start MATLAB, you probably get a window looking like that. You have a lot of buttons at the top and three main windows here. Actually the center one, the command window, is the most important one. We'll go through that in a while. Here the current folder is showing all the files which pop up or are in the folder defined here in the path. We don't need this at the moment, so I just close this window. Similarly, for the workspace here, I close it. We need that, and I would like to have the screen a bit more simple. Okay, the leftover is the command window, and the command window is a bit more complicated and more comfortable calculator. So you can just type in, for instance, 3 plus 8 and get the answer. Or sinus 7 minus log 6. You get an answer. Okay, that's the functionality of a calculator. What is more and better is that you can define variables very easily. So you don't need any declaration, just type it in. A equals 43, it's a definition, or B equals 9. And now you can use these variables to do some simple stuff, like, for instance, add the two variables A and B. Perhaps if you would like to try it out, have a break now. Okay, so the basic idea is that the you type in all the different commands one after the other and get the answer immediately. So let's try to write a program, the first MATLAB program. To write a program, you need something like an editor where you type in the same stuff as we did here. To open an editor, there are two or three ways. One is type in edit into this command window followed by a return. Then the editor pops up here. It might actually, in your case, pop up in the same big window. I just closed this one and this one, the workspace, and probably in your case, when you started the first time, it looks like that. So, in the lower section, you have the command window, in the upper one, the editor. In the editor, you can write down the commands. For instance, again, this same example, A defined, B defined, and C, A plus B. To run this program, you need to store it and press here the green button. To store it, save as, go to a directory where you would like to have your program. It might be, in my case, MATLAB English, let's call it PROC1. I already had that, so it's overwritten. Okay, now it's saved as a file name PROC1. Up here, the file name appears. So it's stored, and we can run it by pressing the green button run. That's not surprising, and when we do that, we get a question. MATLAB is asking whether you would like to include this path to this directory where I just stored the file into the environment. And in this case, just press yes, change folder. Once you've did that, the program is executed. That is, down here, you will notice that these lines pop up and the result is showing up. Okay, so simple as that is the first program. A few hints here. Quite often for the beginner, it's somewhat confusing here with the file name and the directory. So make sure that the file is stored in a directory where you have full writing and reading permission. that is not something directly somewhere, for instance, on a server, but perhaps your USB stick or some other directory where you can read and write data to and from. Okay, the other thing is you have to remember that file names are not allowed to start with a number. If you try that oneproc1 and store that, you get an error message. That's not allowed. That's not a proper name. So we try different things. For instance, have this slash here included in the file name. Again, it's not a valid file name. So a good file name, a valid file name, always starts with a letter. It's case sensitive, so be aware whether it's big capital or a small, in this case P, and try to avoid any special characters like backslash or some plus sign or hyphenation or whatever. The only special character which I know is allowed, and I'm actually using it, the underscore. That's sometimes quite helpful. The extension of these files is always M, just a simple M. So that's a convention, and you need to know that that's a convention how the file has to be named. Okay, we stored it and did executed it by this green button. There's another way to do that, just by writing the program name into the command window. Proc1 without giving the extension, return button, and it should give the same result. Okay, that's the first little program, so we know how the structure is, how we store it, and how to execute this program. Obviously, we would like to extend that to make it a bit more powerful, more complicated stuff here, but that's the whole structure is this one. Right, so what else do we need for a good program? Quite often it's more important to know where to get help from rather than knowing all the stuff. So where can you get help? One thing is perhaps here, obviously, in the section up here, or in the question mark thing, help F1. Let's have a look at the help function. The documentation of MATLAB is quite powerful, and you can even start here as a beginner, for instance, getting started with MATLAB. It's quite neat to go through. You have lots of text and examples which are hopefully easy to understand. So that might be a good way to get some help. The other help is me, if you can get hold of me. The third one is that you just cry help. Let's see what pops up. Lots of stuff, more than you would like to know, at least at the beginning. Help is powerful to get a quick hint what to do, though it's best to use once you know where to start. For instance, you would like to do sinus calculation, and pretty obvious it's sign, which is the command. So just press help sign. Then it gives a little statement here, a bit of text, how to use this command, sign from X, and what it is. So it's the argument in radians. Ah, it's not degree. Then what is quite helpful, quite often, to look down here, see also asin, okay, the inversion of the sign, and sine d, what that is, pops up once you press on it. Then sine d is showing up to be the sine of the argument in degrees. Okay, and by pressing these help buttons, it's quite easy to come from one question to different answer, and you find other tools or commands which are linked to the one you were looking for. Okay, in the script, I hope I've everything covered I just explained in the last few minutes. Common problems. One is this path with which is not properly set. No permission to write or read in this path. The M file that you have to know number at the first character, and no funny strange characters in it. And then, probably not for the English speaking world, the decimal point is actually the dot in German, it's the comma. So make sure that you have always 3 point 1.4 rather than 3.14. Confusion arises quite often by bad naming, and for instance, declaration of any variable with a small l is misleading or can be confused with the one. So avoid that. Anyway, what about octave? As said before, it's pretty similar, same structure of file name, same commands, or at least the basic commands are the same. It looks very similar, a bit like MATLAB 10 or 15 years ago, which is fine. So try it out if you don't have MATLAB. So we've written the first program. What next? In the next lecture, we'll have a look at for and while loops. Another hint, all the lectures you can find on the YouTube channel, it's given here, or the whole course programming on this here on the OLAT server of my university. You need to log in as a guest, and there you can find all the script, for instance. Okay, see you in the next lecture. Bye for now.